I'm Executive Deputy Mayor of Cape Town, Grant Haskins, City of Cape Town officials, board members and founders of ZipZap, proud parents, friends, and above all, young people of the ZipZap family. Delivering an address for an occasion that has been a dream for 16 years is a great responsibility. Or so I thought, until I cast my mind back to an occasion in my own life that was 16 years in the making. And that was 12 years of schooling and 4 years of university, when I graduated from the University of Cape Town with a master's degree in marine biology. The speaker at my graduation ceremony that day was the distinguished Professor John Simpson. Reflecting on his speech has helped me enormously in writing this one, because it turns out that I can't remember a single word he said. This liberating discovery enables me to proceed without any fear that I might inadvertently influence anyone here to abandon promising careers in the arts, entertainment, or creative industries. Comparing today to my graduation ceremony may be a bit of a long shot, but the point is that today, age 16, ZipZap has come of age. One of the many things I learned at university was this, written by the Greek author Plutarch: what we achieve inwardly will change outer reality. That is an astonishing statement, and yet proven 1,000 times every day of our lives. It expresses in part our individual connection with the outside world, the fact that we touch each other's lives simply by existing. But how much more has ZipZap touched other people's lives? And here I am reminded of the Nigerian poet, Ben Okri, who speaks of how to make possible the impossible, how to turn the ordinary moment into the legendary, how to begin a great questioning of ourselves that can shift our thinking into new voiced energy and an era of personal and communal rebirth. And he says, "Never again will we stand on the threshold of a new age. We that are here now are touched in some mysterious way with the ability to change and make the future. Those who wake to the wonder of this magic moment, who wake to the possibilities of this charged conjunction, are the chosen ones who have chosen to act, to free the future, to open it up, to consign prejudices to the past, to open up the magic casement of the human spirit onto a more shining world." And Okri's words resonate for me when I think of ZipZap, because ZipZap epitomizes this new century African energy. ZipZap is in fact an agent of change. As a life experience for young people, social circus is an extremely powerful way of building confidence, respect, self-esteem, and trust amongst young people from diverse communities. ZipZap is a catalyst for personal and communal rebirth, because it brings healing into people's lives. It makes a unique contribution towards the development of the future leaders of our country through life-changing experiences that are in fact enduring and profound. A young adult from Langa Township and a girl from a wealthy suburb like Hout Bay work together on the trapeze. He the catcher, she trusts him and is dependent on him for her safety. Prejudice disappears as the two performers develop confidence in themselves and a new way of seeing, knowing, and understanding each other. This is the magic of ZipZap. But ladies and gentlemen, it goes much further than that. Since 1994, ZipZap has facilitated an outreach program with the aim of bringing the benefits of social circus to children and youth who have special needs or who are unable to attend the regular practices. For the past 5 years, ZipZap has been running workshops in cooperation with Medicine Sans Frontier for children receiving antiretroviral treatment at the Nolungile Clinic in Khayelitsha. At the workshops, children who have faced hardship and ill health are given the chance to have fun in a circus environment whilst developing their physical strength and abilities and gaining self-confidence and hope for the first time in their lives. As one of the performers said, "ZipZap gives me the chance to be the kid that the world is trying to stop me from being." Looking back over 16 years, ZipZap has achieved so many milestones, performing for Nelson Mandela's birthday, organizing more than 20 international tours, collaborative performances with the Australian Circus School for the Commonwealth Games, recognized by Cirque du Soleil for its achievements in social circus, and in the process, transforming the lives of hundreds of young people. But I think that there is no greater milestone than the roof wetting that we are celebrating here tonight. After 16 years of dreaming, ZipZap has its own multi-million rand circus tent in a prime spot in the center of Cape Town, and this is no dream. In just a few moments, the magic of ZipZap will be upon us, as Once Upon a Circus is performed. But I think a few words of introduction are necessary. Way back in 1996, when we were all a lot younger and had less gray hair, on this very spot where the ZipZap children have built this stage, ZipZap put up a small circus tent and hosted a show called Trick. One of the stars of that show was a beautiful boy from Langa with a most incredible smile. Mbuleka Mbeka, fondly known as Shorty, was the ringmaster, the trapeze artist, and the comic, and he had firmly embedded himself in everyone's hearts. After the evening performance, Shorty went to Brent, gave him an audio cassette, and said that one day he wanted to do a trapeze act to the music on the tape. The song was, "I Believe I Can Fly." But sadly, that was not to be. During the show's run, the performers decided to have a swim at Melkbos Beach, and Shorty was caught in backwash and never made it back to the shore. Shorty would have been 26 today and will be opening the show this evening with his trademark welcome. As you can imagine, ZipZap has engaged with many organizations and individuals over the 16 years, and tonight would never have been possible without them. I'd like to thank them all, the ZipZap Board of Trustees, the City of Cape Town and the Provincial Government of the Western Cape, the Cape Town Partnership, the National Lottery Distribution Trust, Cirque du Soleil, Artscape, Gearhouse, Score Metals, Old Mutual, Caltex, Sekanjalo, Dish for the catering tonight, Security Projects, the Engelhorn and Schaefer families, Tony Mansfield and Mel Raby. And I'm sure there are many more people whose names I haven't mentioned, but ZipZap is eternally grateful to all for their generosity of spirit. In closing, I'd like to say that in my opinion, the future identity that South Africa seeks will be discovered through creative, entrepreneurial, and socially minded people who make a difference by caring about the well-being of individuals and their communities. We call these people social entrepreneurs. Brent and Laurence epitomize what is meant by the term social entrepreneur, because they work innovatively and tirelessly to build the broader ZipZap family. I think that they and others who follow similar paths are the prophets, going where others cannot. Leaders, visionaries, adventurers, riggers, choreographers, scriptwriters, actors, circus performers, lighting technicians, costume designers, the makers of music and dance, they sense the future before it happens. And South Africa needs passionate, committed, and creative people, because the future of this extraordinary country will be made not by committees or cabinets and cliques, but by the incredible young people such as we will see performing here this evening. Non-conformists all, they are led by intuition and fed by imagination as they redraw the maps and rewrite the rules. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you very, very much for honoring ZipZap by being with us this evening. I know that we will all leave here uplifted of mind and spirit.